Rat Kings. A collection of rats with entangled tails forming a single mass of writhing rodents. What is the evidence of these kings? We will start with the folklore. The earliest case goes back to the mid-1500s, and while most purported rat kings occur in Germany, claims of rat kings exist all over the world, and usually by the black rat species. They are seen as a bad omen, carrying plague and ill luck. Historically, any rat king was usually killed upon discovery due to this superstition that they brought disease and famine. Rat kings were also believed to have either a single mind or a leader controlling the intertwined congregation. So how does a rat king come about? There are a number of theories as to how rat kings form. There are also those who think that rat kings are impossible or a hoax. But let's start by looking into how rats could get their tails knotted. One explanation suggests dense populations of rats may get their tails stuck together through natural oils produced by their bodies and tails, which can become sticky if pressed together. Added to that are feces from the large number of rats, and perhaps enough rats could get their tails glued together this way. Another theory says that huddling together during cold or damp months could increase the chances that rat tails stick together and become knotted as they struggle to move. Furthermore, some suggestions say that rats become entangled during pregnancy or birth, though this is considered one of the least likely explanations, as the chances they would survive to grow up seems low. One of the most famous cases of rat kings was in Germany in 1828 with a count of 32 rats. Another case was discovered by farmers who actually found two rat kings in the same roof, one with 28 rats and the other with 14. Upon untying the rat king's tails, there is clear evidence of bone impression and unnaturally curved spines. This would mean that the rat kings don't form after death, as one theory predicts. A book written by Martin Hart in 1982 lists 50 rat kings, with most cases he believed to be genuine. As there are plenty examples of hoaxes and frauds, it can be hard to accurately deduce the existence of rat kings one way or the other. Another counter-argument is that rat kings should be able to separate themselves, even if it means gnawing their own tails off. I am going to present another theory, which has likely never been considered before. To recap, rat king occurrences are described as accidental or circumstantial due to tight gatherings and various sticky substances, happening only after death, happening because of some birth defect, or not being possible at all. First, we need to establish some basic things we know about rats. 1. Rats are among the cleanest mammals in the world. The reason this is important is because the odds of rats going long enough periods without grooming whatsoever to the point that their tails stick together is rather unlikely. Despite how much hate rats get from humans, they are in fact very clean and hygienic animals. Second, rats have prehensile tails, meaning their tails can grasp and wrap around objects. In this case, that would be other rat tails. Third, rats are extremely social creatures and have their own hierarchies and alphas, or leaders. This is an important principle in understanding where the king comes from in rat kings, or why rat kings supposedly follow a single rat in the group. Fourth, rats communicate a lot with each other. They sing when they are happy and can even be peer pressured by other rats into doing things they dislike. Because rats are very smart and resourceful, it is doubtful that if they end up tied together, they wouldn't be able to break free. Their intelligence is precisely why finding a rat king would be so rare. Not only would they wish to untie themselves for cleanliness reasons, they are problem solvers who could simply untie themselves in the event they do become entangled. This is the explanation for rat kings that has not been explored. Rat kings form because they choose to form them. I can think of three main reasons why a rat king would assemble. Rats facing a deadly predator could tie their tails together in order to intimidate whatever is hunting them. Appearing larger or changing appearance is a mainstay in animal defense mechanisms. Group efforts among social creatures is commonplace. The next reason that rat kings form is in order to dominate other rival clans. By becoming a king, they can potentially overpower other rats with ease, and then disassembling once dominance is established. Rat kings are recreational. As ethology grows as a science, we are finding more and more animals do things simply because they like to. Perhaps it is a game or a group exercise of some sort. This is not something that should be discounted merely because the bias biology has against animals doing anything other than necessary for food and reproduction. All three explanations are plausible, depending on the situation and the rats involved. If the lead rat wants to gather into a rat king, likely the other rats will agree to join. Afterwards, they may separate, but sometimes they may not want to. It is up to each individual rat king to decide, as all rats have their own personality and life experiences. Binding tails together is much like humans linking arms, or even tying rope around each other so no one gets lost or separated. Rats could just as well be doing the same thing. It's an easy and natural way for rats to ensure that they don't get split, especially if searching for a new home. The jury is still out on rat kings, but approaching the possibility from the perspective that rats are intelligent, sentient creatures will open the doors to observing and understanding the endless capabilities all animals possess.